Hi everyone and welcome. In this video, we are going to deploy a Server 2016 template to be used as the infrastructure machine in our vSphere private cloud. I'm going to do that using the program automation scripts for our cloud infrastructure. That is the command that we're going to be using, a little bit different from Windows because I'm running this on my Mac. And we'll launch our script. We're going to be connecting into VCSA1. And I have to authenticate into the environment. Okay, we are in. I'm going to pick option 2, which is deploy. I'm going to deploy and customize a virtual machine from template. I know all of that information that I need. And we will wait for it to find the templates we can deploy from. I'm going to choose the fifth one, which is Server 2016. And we have to give it a name for the virtual machine. Based on the lab instructions, that is going to be the virtual machine name. It's going to automatically use my resource pool, my folder, and my data store to save the virtual machine into the environment. I want my host name to match the virtual machine name, so I'll say yes. I'm going to add a set of credentials for myself. And I'm going to assign the network adapter into port group 1. It's going to be static IP. Put in my IP address. Subnet mask. Default gateway. I want to add a DNS server in. And I do want to power it on after it's deployed. And I'm ready to go. So we'll allow that to deploy out. It's going to take a minute or so for that to deploy and power on. I'm going to pause the video and we'll come back once that's finished to carry on and do the post-deployment configuration. Okay, that's been a minute or so. Let's exit out of the menu. And we'll try pinging that virtual machine, make sure it's up and running. Right, that was successful. Should be able to open a remote desktop session and go in and perform the post-deployment configuration. Okay, we successfully logged in. I'll accept the network. And there's not a huge amount that we have to do here. One is we want to grab the Firefox browser rather than using the built-in browser for Windows. So I'm going to disable Internet Explorer security so that I can download from various websites much more easily. And one other thing I want to do before I start on that is I'm going to change the network adapter name from Ethernet 0 to production, which we will be using later on when we have multiple network adapters. So I'll rename this. And that's all I have to do for that. Right, let's fire up Internet Explorer. And we will go to find Firefox. Right, we have Firefox up and running. We need to get the PuTTY application. So that we're going to have a method of getting secure shell access into our vSphere infrastructure once we have that up and running. And we're going to drop this out on our desktop. And the other thing that we need to grab is WinSCP. And then we'll install WinSCP, and we're finished after that. Okay, I paused the video while I was installing WinSCP. I think you're quite capable of installing a software app. Close that down, and if I minimize Firefox, we can see that WinSCP is installed, PuTTY's installed, we have Firefox installed. We are now ready to start building the rest of our infrastructure, and this will be the machine that we'll be using as our management workstation throughout all of the labs that are going to be part of the course. It's the end of the video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.